The views and opinions of this broadcast do not reflect the views and opinions of Armed Media, UNU Productions and its affiliates. Enjoy the show.
Things are different today. I hear every mother say, cooking bread. husband's just a drag. So she buys an instant cake, and she finds a frozen steak, and goes running for the shelter of her mother's little helper. And to help her on her way, get her through her busy day. Doctor, please, some more of these outside the door. She's a formal. What a drag it is getting old. Men just aren't the same today. I hear every mother say they just don't appreciate that you get tired. They're so hard to satisfy. You can tranquilize your man. So go running for the shelter of a mother's little helper. And for help you through the night, help to minimize your flight. Doctor, please, some more of these outside the door. She took four more. What a drag it is getting old. Life's just much too hard today. I hear every mother say the pursuit of happiness just seems a bore. And if you take more of those, you will get overdose. No more running for the shelter of a mother's little helper. They just helped you on your way through your busy dying day.
Savino Wine Preservation System is wine preservation glassware. Savino is an easy-to-use wine preservation system that allows you to enjoy your favorite wines anytime without waiting for an occasion. Open any bottle with confidence, knowing that you can enjoy the full original flavor of Tuesday's wine on Saturday. For more information, visit us at...
And welcome to Rock Talk. We are here with Sargasm, a band out of Long Island, New York. Welcome, fellas.
Hey, how you doing?
How are you? Thanks for having us.
Hello!
So we're here with Brian, we're here with Billy, and we're here with Sean. So that's the bassist, the singer, guitarist, and the drummer. Am I correct?
Yes, that is correct. Boom.
Right on. So what type of music do you guys play?
Rock and roll. A little bit of metal. But, you know, straight up rock and roll.
Nice.
Make the boys headbang and the girls shake their hips. That's our goal.
Yeah, basically.
That's a great goal to have. So tell me a brief history about your band.
Well, when did we form?
I was back in high school, almost 10 years ago, which freaks me out.
Yeah.
That's okay. Everything takes time. Me and Billy started in high school with another group of guys, and then over the years, people came and went. But me and Billy kind of stuck through, and now we have Sean, who's been in the band for quite a while now, and our guitar player can't be here, Maddie. He joined about 2 years ago, so the lineup's always been weird, but now it's been solid for a while, so
I've been with the guys since about 2013, our past two releases, I was fortunate to be a part of,
and they're the best two releases we got.
Hell yeah.
Right on, so it sounds like you guys are friends, and some of you kind of grew up together.
Yeah, me and Billy live, town over, really. Went to the same high school, so.
Brian was friends with my brother first, and then,
he's a nutcase, I love him.
Yeah, and then, he was trying to get me in the band, but I wouldn't get up to go to practice, but then finally you, came to my door and made me come to practice, and I was like, oh, this shit's awesome.
Can Billy come out and play the bass today?
Yeah. And then I fell in love with the band, because the music was awesome, so I stuck with it.
Right on. So, I have to ask you guys, how did you come up with this name?
Oh, God.
It's all Brian over here.
Brian's the mastermind.
I like trying to make different words go together a lot. And I think one day I was just taking a shower and then the name kind of hit me in the head. But that was supposed to be a song title. And then I thought, no, that's just too good of a name. So I threw it to the guys of the band, and they were like, yeah, that sounds kind of offensive, but not.
Yeah.
So we just kind of rolled with that. I don't know why I think of the things I think of.
We started as Delirient, and then some other artist out there was named Delirient, so we thought we had to change it. So we were like, oh, shit, we're all trying to come up with names, and all of ours sucked. And then Brian was like, how about Sargasm? Like, that's pretty solid.
The name we had before was taken from a DJ in, Africa, and our old guitar player was like, I'm going to go on YouTube and fight this guy. And we were like, that's a bad idea. And then after that, we changed the name.
Yeah, I've had bands on before that had to fight for their name and change it. So, yeah, they do the copyright
laws. All the trademarks.
Yeah, the trademarks, yep. So, who is your musical and non-musical influences? Like, who's inspired you to do what you do?
Jack Nicholson. Jack Nicholson's been a pretty big influence on all of us.
Yeah,
a non-musical influence.
Yeah, even one of our songs is about Jack Nicholson.
Yeah, one of our songs is about Jack Nicholson, so he's pretty important to the band.
Right on.
I really like that. It's true. Jack Nicholson, there's this mysteriousness about him, and his, the way he carries is cool. We just want to put that in the music somehow.
And earlier musically, we wanted to be like CKY and like Metallica. And then now we're kind of trying to be like Queens of Stone Age a little bit.
Yeah, well, I think the band definitely became slightly more progressive and filed down over time. And we're definitely trying to pull influences from bands like Queens of Stone Age. I know, me personally, I'm a big fan of Mastodon. I think
right on.
A lot of the guys
that we all have personally.
Yeah, we all bring something. I feel like we all have a nice core that's similar, and then we each bring like kind of some unique elements to the table for sure.
Like the music's heavy, but like I'll be on the sideline listening to like Jeff Buckley or Tom Waits, which doesn't really transpose in the music, but sometimes it does to me. But like I'm sure the rest of the guys have their own kind of like weird little thing they listen to. But like Faith No More too.
Yeah, Faith No More. Faith No More.
Oh, totally. When you guys were what in sixth grade, they were out and really very popular.
Yeah.
Now they're back, so I'm loving it.
I'm glad they're back. There's a lot of different bands coming back. It's pretty crazy and cool at the same time. So
yeah, a lot of things coming back, yeah.
Yeah, everything good circles around.
Who
writes your songs, and what are they about? Do they have any hidden meanings to them?
Well, usually Brian has a million riffs. He kind of brings it to the table sometimes, and then we structure the whole thing and, like, fine-tune it.
Uh-huh.
And,
I guess lyrically, I used to be pretty on the nose with it. And, like, when I was younger, the songs would be a little bit more like a story, and it'd be kind of campy.
Uh-huh.
And then as I got older, it would kind of become more cryptic, but I would make it cryptic in a way where people would be like, is he talking about his love life, his soul? And then I'm like, nah, I'm talking about refrigerators.
Oh.
I want to see if people are, like, paying attention in a weird way, but some songs are just, you know, it could be about love, it could be about horror or robbing banks or, you know.
So kind
of about me personally that I don't want to talk about in front of a therapist.
Yeah. So it kind of sounds like Bob Dylan-ish to me.
Oh, that's cool. Hey, he's the man. I'll take it.
He is the man. He has a new book coming out, too.
Oh, he does?
Yes, he does.
Ooh.
I will put that on the Rock Talk Facebook page so you can check that out. So,
nice. Very cool, very cool.
What is your biggest challenge as a band?
Biggest challenge is trying to be productive and trying to keep everybody afloat and everybody interested still. And that's the main thing.
Yeah, and
trying to keep up with times, I'd say trying to, write new material that, we are completely and utterly proud of. And, you know, I think that's a big thing for me personally. I like to make sure, like...
That's a good one.
You know, I think writing things that we're proud of is obviously, like, not the easiest thing, but I think we take it seriously in the sense where we don't really, like, settle for something that, like, if someone isn't happy, we try to make sure everyone in the band is happy and everyone's kind of, like, on the same page and proud of the songs. I think that's definitely a...
Yeah, sometimes it's not easy to do, especially, like, if you're in a room full of guys and we're trying to figure out how to make a song, you know... Sometimes it can get hard for everybody to be on the same page, but the lineup now, we're pretty good with that, you know?
This is definitely the best lineup the band's had. I think we're very, we've been the most productive with the four of us.
Yeah.
Yeah, and like,
we've got a lot done.
Everybody has great ideas. Like, if we're writing a song, Sean will be like, oh, what about we do something like this here? And we're like, you know what? That's a great idea. And it's just, everybody's just.
You know what the biggest challenge for me is trying to make people on Long Island like the music. I mean, when people hear it, they like it, but that's not the style they're into, especially the scenes that we're in.
Yeah.
So every time we kind of like maybe go into Queens or Manhattan or play somewhere else, people are really like, oh, we like that. We get it. But around here, some people might be like, oh, that's cool. That's not their cup of tea. So I guess the biggest challenge for me is like trying to see, to get everybody to just be like, okay, I get it. I get what you're doing. Because at first, people are kind of confused.
Well, in a few years, when you're uber famous, they're going to be like, hey, I know him.
No, we're famous now because we're on this radio show. So I think we did pretty damn good.
Well, I mean, like, everybody knows who you are, you know? And that'll happen. That'll happen. I'm totally sure of that. So as far as the challenges that you've overcame, it sounds like that you guys have like a brotherhood, that you respect one another and you respect each other's respect each other.
It's like I always thought of bands as being a gang.
I thought of it as like you're in a relationship with four other people.
Yeah, I'm like married to three dudes.
It's true. It is true. You have to be receptive to everybody's input, and you know, you're gonna have growing pains. Totally.
I was always into it, like being a mafia too. Like, don't go against the family, and like, but we'll get your back if you got ours, kind of thing. And, like,
yeah.
Color, you
know, damn right.
The color thing.
Yeah.
I mean, that's cool.
Well, you are New Yorkers from Long Island.
good observation.
Long Island, I'll be in there.
Long Island, hey, yo.
So where have you guys... Where have you guys performed?
All over New York.
We haven't unfortunately done too much branching out of our state, but we can be found regularly performing in either Nassau or Suffolk County on Long Island. We've been, you know, in the Queens, Brooklyn, Manhattan area as well. We've been looking to kind of get out. We really need to start doing, like, the states that kind of surround us a little more. Like, I want to go play Boston and go down to, like, Philadelphia and things like that.
Yeah, I want to go to California.
Jersey, yeah, I mean, California, obviously.
Well, yeah, you guys, you know, get out here, I'll help you get some shows.
That's amazing, absolutely, yeah.
Yeah, fortunately, you know, it's just like, life is a big thing, you know, getting
You're in a relationship with four other people, and you all have to get on the same schedule, make sure you can, you know, take time off work and everything, so.
But we make it happen, you know.
Yeah, we make it work.
You get us a gig, though, we'll come.
We'll come straight there.
If you book us, we will come.
If you book us, we will come. We do children's birthday parties, too.
Right on. Yeah, you got to pass the torch to those kids.
Exactly. Train the young rockers.
Get it in their heads now, and then sell.
Do you guys have any shows coming up?
Yes, we do.
Yeah, November 24th in Amityville at the Revolution Club.
Nice.
It's like a showcase. It's a whole bunch of different bands playing. It's a really cool venue. I know the guys that run it, so...
Yeah, they always do right by us.
So we're always comfortable playing there. I like the stage.
Revolution's a great place. They get cool acts going through there.
Now, how do you guys promote your band? Do you have a website, Facebook page? Tell me about that.
Yeah, we got facebook.com/sargasmmusic. We also have Bandcamp, which is Sargasm New York. And we're also on Instagram as well, which is Sargasm New York. We use all of them all the time. They're fun to go on and kind of, like, mess with people and stuff.
Yeah, if you follow us on Facebook, there's basically links to all of our social media from there. But, yeah, we're pretty much mostly on Instagram, Facebook, and Bandcamp, and also SoundCloud.
Okay.
Right, yeah.
And how can fans get access to your music? Do you have anything on, like, iTunes?
Oh, yeah.
Spotify,
iTunes.
Amazon. All of that. YouTube as well. Everything's put
out. Yeah, a few months ago, we put out a music video for our song Always, which was the first song that we released off of our most recent EP, which is called Monster of the Week. Just something for the people listening, definitely go check out that release. It's 5 songs. And like I said, there's a music video for Always, which is on YouTube, and all the songs can be heard on Spotify, and they can be bought off iTunes, our Bandcamp, etc. But definitely check out Monster of the Week.
Okay, I will make sure that I link all those to the interview on the Rock Talk USA webpage. Yeah, of course. So, do you have any advice for any people out there looking to start a band?
Do it because you want to.
Yeah, I mean, that's the most important thing. Definitely try to start it up without any, like alternative motives. Like, you know what I mean? Obviously, everyone wants to be famous. Everyone wants money. But it's really not, like, a realistic goal. So I feel like the people that are in it because it's what they love to do really see the most results and kind of benefit the most from it.
Play shows, play, and go to shows.
Go to shows, like, make friends. The local scene.
Always make friends. And
yeah, that's a big thing. I think a big thing, especially for, like, the local up-and-coming bands, is kind of, like, building, like, a little network for yourself. Like, finding out what other bands that are in your area that are kind of similar to you.
Start
Yeah, and then trying to start a scene up, or like find your scene and kind of like, you know, make your friends and work your way in.
And put on better shows if you support other bands, become friends with them,
and dress like it's a party every day. I mean, seriously, wear denim on denim, just rock and roll.
Have a good time all the time.
Right, do a metronome.
I agree with all of that. That's excellent advice.
You know what the best advice I ever got was from our old recording teacher in high school. And I remember I cursed on stage in front of, like, the whole school. And then after the show, this is, like, one of our first shows, and I came off the stage and I saw my teacher and I said, oh, I'm really sorry. I cursed. And he just, like, pulled me aside and said, listen, shut up. Don't ever apologize for nothing. And then he walked away. And I was like, that's awesome as hell.
Shout out to Mr. Lacani.
That's great. So this is just a fun question, and I'd like all of you to answer it. Can you name three songs that are on your recently played list?
Three songs on recently played list.
Oh, on like ours, like on my phone or something?
Yeah.
Oh, I don't listen to music on my phone. I'm gonna go last is what I'm gonna do. Sean, what do you got?
Alright, so my recently played list, the first song on my recently played list is My Plague by Slipknot.
Nice.
The second song on my recently played list is Have You Ever by The Offspring. And the third song on my recently played list is Saucy by a band called Polyphia. That's more of like a newer song. But
mine is I got Go With the Flow by Queens of Stone Age, Got the Life by Korn, and then you know that song Feels by Calvin Harris? I like that song. I like Calvin Harris.
That's, right.
That's really out of right field, but you know, whatever.
Sweet.
I put a spell on you.
Nice.
Right. Because I wanted to cover it in my own head and be like, you put a spell on me, and now I'm yours. I think we should do that later, boys, but that's something we should talk about later. Probably not. And Wolverine Bub. No, that's just a compilation I was looking for of Wolverine from the X-Men movie.
I love Larry. The X-Men.
Oh, X-Men's great. Let's get into that in a bit, okay? Lara Lynn, I think the song's Bobby Baby. She did the music for the True Detective soundtrack on season 2.
Okay.
I love little folk music like that. And Weezer, Suzanne.
That's a good song.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's very nice.
So you have an eclectic collection there. That's kind of like I am. I'm all over the place with music. It just depends on how I'm feeling.
Yeah, I mean, it just depends on the mood, you know?
Yeah.
And the weather.
If you could, like, steal credit or take credit for any great song out there, what song would you claim?
Oh, shit.
Oh, that's a great question.
That is a good question.
I think about that all the time.
There's so many.
Oh, I know.
When I hear it, I'm always like, why didn't I write that? But when, like, somebody asks me, I'm like, crap, what is it? The Fun Machine Took a Poop and Died by Queens of the Stone Age. That song is, like, six minutes of, like, just pure riffing, but it's, like, it's just so goofy and almost carnival-esque, you know? That's one of them for me.
Yeah, it's kind of like Frank Zappa.
Yeah, it's really wacky. You know, I just love it, but I don't know. I'm sure I'll think of something else. What about you, Billy?
Is it When the Levee Breaks? When the Levee Breaks, Led Zeppelin.
Oh,
that,
yeah,
song. That's my favorite.
I'm just gonna go with Somebody in Love by Jefferson Airplane.
Yeah, that's nice.
That song is phenomenal.
Any song by Tom Petty.
Because that'll get you on the chart.
Yeah, I'll get you on the chart.
Ooh, you know what song I wish I made? Chandelier by Sia. When that song hits, I'm just like, damn.
Yeah.
Damn, it's good.
What's that Aerosmith
song
that we fucking love?
Oh,
baby, blue.
Yeah, Jaded.
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 Oh, that's awesome. I love that song.
Awesome.
So, what about you? What song would you do if you had the chance to take the credit?
Oh, you know what song that I really love is Friends by Led Zeppelin.
Nice. Yeah.
Great song.
Yeah. Okay.
A solid.
Like deep cut right there.
Now we know who we're talking to.
Yeah.
It's kind of like, you know, the advice I give my kids, you know?
That's
just
nice.
Just how to be a person that loves others unconditionally.
I can get behind that big time.
Well, that reminds me also, you know what the song I wish I wrote? The theme song for Friends. Because that person's loaded now.
Yeah, that guy's rolled. The entire Beatles catalog, I'll take that.
Yeah, there you go.
There is so much money to be made and creativity in theme songs.
That's like a dream of mine,
to
write a theme song for a show that like is syndicated
right.
20 years, so that way I'm just getting royalties through the mail. But also to just be like, oh, cool, I made a theme song for a show.
Yeah, also with movies. I'm working on a new film myself right now, and we're going to start filming in April. And it's a horror movie, of course.
Nice.
But, you know, just getting... here in California, if you want to send me an audition tape, you can. So you can do that through, like, Messenger, if you'd like.
Awesome. Can we all do that?
Oh, sarcasm cameo.
But yeah, you know, there's all kinds of avenues for music.
Yeah, soundtracking has always kind of been a little...
We actually,
We tried doing that with a friend of ours who's doing a college film. No, he went to school for it, and now he's, like, really pushing with, like, Sundance film festivals and all that.
Yeah.
And
independent film just used always, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, this guy Joseph, he's been doing movies here on the island, and he recently just asked us for one of our songs to put in, and it's cool, just putting your music out there if it's not on YouTube. I'd like to see it on a TV show.
Yeah, it'd be pretty cool.
Yeah, do it. That's definitely a way in, and, you know, it's a piece of the movie or a piece of someone else's creativity in a joint effort, you know? I think
right,
it's
yeah.
really awesome.
Like a collage of different minds. You know?
Yeah.
If we could be in the trailer for, like, an upcoming Liam Neeson or Keanu Reeves movie, that would be dope.
So you said you like Jack Nicholson, and he is referenced in some of your music. Tell me a little bit more about that.
We have one kind of cowboyish type of song. And the vibe of the song is—it's a cowboy kind of thing. But the lyrically, they don't make much sense. There's not much to a story of it. But the lyrics kind of just like, what would Jack Nicholson do? And I don't know. I was in a big Jack Nicholson kick. There's just something about him that I wanted to put his energy and his mystique and coolness into the song.
The name of the song's Five Easy Riders. So we took Easy Rider and
Five Easy Pieces. We took both titles of the films and we just kind of put them together. So it's Five Easy Riders, which is on Spotify, YouTube, Amazon.
Awesome. I didn't get to hear that.
I'll send you all the music, too. Yeah.
Awesome. I know we're going to be playing two of your songs tonight.
Right. Very sick.
Awesome.
Yeah. So is there anything else that you'd like to let the listeners know?
Do like a shout out to like, where we record and all that. We recorded our EP with our good friend John, and we're at Front Row Recordings, which is located in Valley Stream. The EP was mastered by our friends over at Westfall Recording in Farmingdale. Shouts out to everybody involved for just making
shout out
sure our production sounds good and, you know, really giving us a nice punch. We're all really happy with how this most recent one came out. It's something we're all definitely proud of. Again, definitely, if you're listening, make sure to check out our music video on YouTube for our song Always. Thank you to anyone who's ever listened to us. Thank you to our friends in Australia. Friends in Australia that are really into our music.
Yeah.
They put us on their podcast. They gave us a really nice review.
And London.
Okay. Yeah, we've gotten some cool like recognition in places that we never thought we would be listened to.
You know, I've heard that. Your dad was telling me about that.
We were recently featured in a Classic Rock magazine, which is predominantly
London-based.
Yeah, it's a London-based publication, but it can be found in America at, like, Barnes and Noble, places like that. And they actually featured our title song off of the EP, which is called
Monster of the Week.
Monster of the Week. It's on their CD, and we're the first track. And then they gave us a little write-up inside the magazine.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
For hooking us up with some attention and, helped us out. Anthony Capozzi, he was also featured on that song. He's another local artist. He's a good friend of ours.
Yeah, Anthony Capozzi from Thrace.
Shout out to Capozzi!
And thanks to all the haters, man.
Thanks for that, guys.
I let the haters be my
They gave you a hard time at that one show for running a solid state and. Oh my god.
Oh, I ripped that guy a new one from that whole set.
Yeah, that guy was nice.
Is that the story you had?
Yeah. I was going to tell a funny story about how Billy showed up to have a bass without a bass.
Oh, shit.
And we were about to go on, and he didn't have a bass, and it was just, and I looked at him. With a look of hard, disgusting, pure anger.
Yeah,
I was so furious.
Yeah.
But I digress.
We got to the show. I was like, you know what? I'm not going to even start drinking right now. I'm gonna be slow tonight. Everything's up there. I'm good. And then right before we were supposed to go on, I sit there and I go, holy shit, I forgot my bass.
Yeah.
And then our good friend Kostas, who was playing the show, he's a bass player, let me borrow his. But that was a pretty big fuck up. Sean looked me with devil eyes.
Yeah, I was like, oh
shit.
I was like, you know what, Billy? I don't care how you think this. You go get yourself a bass right now.
Yeah.
We got to be on Station 5, bass.
Yeah, I don't know what's going on with me that day.
Well, how did you get a bass? What happened next?
Our friend who was playing the show, Kostas, he's a bass player, and he was like, you can use mine for the show. So,
yeah, you had a down finish for C standard, though, so it's muddy crap.
He's in Thailand right now.
Yeah, Kostas is from Thailand. Shout out to Kostas. Yeah,
Kostas is one of the greatest guys I've ever seen.
Yeah, he's a good guy.
But he saved me that day.
Yeah.
On murdering me. Because I was a fucking idiot.
I guess you owe him one, right?
Yeah.
It was almost like a dad just looking at you like, what have you done?
I know, dude. So sad.
You had one job.
Right?
One job.
Bring your fucking instrument, dude. Yeah, that was pretty dumb.
Well, I bet you'll never do it again.
Absolutely
I'll
not.
Make sure of it.
Mostly because I don't want Sean to look at me that way anymore.
I'm glad we got here.
That's pretty funny.
Here we are.
What kinds of instruments do you guys play? I know you play guitar, but what brand do you guys like the best?
I play a Parker guitar. One of my favorite guitar players used a Parker. I don't think anyone uses them anymore. I think they got bought out a couple of years ago, so they're kind of hard to find. That's why I'm glad I still have it. I write and I record and practice with that thing, play shows with it. So that's my go-to guitar, a Parker. Everything else I play is cool, but that one just, like, I've had that guitar for, like, 15 years, so it's just in my DNA.
Nice.
I played an Ibanez for a while, but then my brother bought me a Dean bass. It's like fluorescent green.
So ugly in the coolest way.
Oh, I love that guitar. In your pictures? That's freaking rad. I love that.
Yeah. So I'm playing that now.
And I play a Pearl drum kit.
Nice.
I've always used Pearl drums. Definitely a fan of theirs. I guess I use Zildjian cymbals, Evans skins, Kickford sticks, Tama double pedal, and any kind of used gear that I can afford to make my drum set complete.
I can't do that with guitars where people are like, I just bought 8 more guitars. I'm like, I still use the same one. Like, I don't, if I had the money, I'd probably play with more, but, I just, as long as the car gets there, I don't need a Lamborghini.
I think with instruments, they're kind of an extension to who you are. You know, they're like part of your arm or, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I have this thing where when I go to a guitar center or a Sam Ash that we have around here, I always go to the used gear, not because it's cheaper, but because like they look like ghosts that are like, so somebody loves me, but they gave me away. Will you adopt me? And I just want to play them and let them know it's going to be okay.
That is awesome. That is so cool. That is really, really cool.
And the used gear is always goofier looking, too. I always like the goofy looking stuff.
You know, Steve Miller, he got his guitar out of like a big bucket at a guitar store. Have you heard the story about that?
No, it's funny though.
Yeah, he only had like, I think it was less than $200 to buy a guitar. And there was nothing in the store for $200, but there was this like old garbage can full of instruments.
Used parts.
Yeah. And he pulled out this guitar and he was like, okay, I'll take it. It was really strange. He'd never seen anything like it before, and he still plays it today.
And it's worth millions of dollars.
Oh, yeah. People have offered him millions for it. Yeah.
I have one little guitar that I saw at a thrift store. It was $2, and it was a kid's guitar, but it had, like, painted really cheesy-looking flames on it.
Uh-huh.
And then when I picked it up, it actually had an input, and I was like, wait, I could plug this thing in? So the next record, I'm probably going to use that little toy.
Awesome.
It's so out of tune, and I love it.
That's so cool. Last question here. Who is your favorite Ninja Turtle?
Whoa, yeah. Michelangelo. No. It's between Donatello and Michelangelo for me.
That's some commitment, Jesus Christ.
When I was little, it was Donatello. Now I'm kind of like, I like Mikey, dude.
Mikey's great.
He's
the
spirit.
I always loved Mikey, but when you're a front man of a band and you got to take some leadership roles, sometimes I'm always looking at Leonardo, okay? Plus, you got two ninja swords. That's pretty cool, so I'm
pretty dope.
I'll go Leonardo.
I have anger issues, so I'm always going to be a big fan of Raphael.
There you go. Matty's totally Donatello, though.
Yeah, he's Donatello.
His guitar's purple.
There you go. There you go, Matty. Yeah, you're Donatello.
Sweet.
I guess we know what we're doing for Halloween next year.
First, this is the vibe, but never pay full price for late fees.
That's right. That's right. Now, that's sound advice, too, right?
Yeah. Two words never been spoken.
Oh, man. I don't get how in the first movie they love pizza. They live in New York City, and they're getting Domino's.
Domino's pizza.
If you look at the Domino's pizza, it doesn't look like a Domino's looks today. It actually looks
like a good pizza.
It doesn't look like the big Domino's.
But they live in Manhattan. They're getting Domino's. And you know what else?
The money.
But the movie was promoted. The movie was promoted by Pizza Hut. Look that up. I'm not kidding.
I always thought that Michelangelo was a little harsh on that guy. They live in a sewer. Of course the guy's going to be late. He doesn't know where the hell they live.
Yeah. I didn't know they delivered in that part of town.
Isn't that like half addressed? Like it's like Harry Potter?
Yeah. Like, give the guy a break, man.
That's a great question. Thank you for asking that.
Thanks for being on the show. I really appreciate you guys stopping in, and all the luck to you guys. And any help I can be, I certainly will be. And we're going to be listening to two of your songs tonight. I don't remember what the names of them are. I already sent them to my producer.
First track I think we sent you was Always, which Sean said before is on YouTube now with the music video.
Okay.
And the second one we're finally releasing, I guess, kind of like another little single, is Bon Voyage.
Nice. That's a great one.
Awesome. Well, thanks again, fellas, and much love to you. And if you're ever out here in California, look me up. We'll go out to dinner.
Hell awesome. Hell yeah.
Thank you very much.
You are the best.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Appeared in 50 homes, not much that sir. I'll explain later. Thank you, sir.
Jimmy John's.
Come in. Sir, did you know your house is on fire?
Yes, I did. Grab a bucket.
Jimmy John's.
Come in.
Sir, did you know your house is on fire?
Grab a bucket.
Jimmy John's.
Come in.
Sir, did you know?
Yes, I did. Grab a bucket.
Jimmy John's.
Come in.
Sir, did you?
Yes, I did. Grab a bucket.
Fire department.
Come in.
Sir, did you know your...
It's okay, Captain. We got it handled. Care for a sandwich?
Thanks, but tell me something.
Shoot.
Why didn't you call the fire department first?
I did.
Jimmy John's, America's favorite sandwich delivery.
And welcome back to Rock Talk. So that was Sargasm out of New York, Long Island. The interview was really good. They're great fellas. I had a lot of fun doing that. I changed the music at last minute because I listened to the whole album, which I got on iTunes. You can too. And I really liked the three that I picked. Monster of the Week, 5 Easy Riders, and Bon Voyage. So those are the ones we played tonight. You can hear the entire album if you get it on iTunes. I'm going to put all the links to everything that is about them on the Rock Talk USA website. So look for that. It'll be up probably Wednesday, Halloween. And speaking of Halloween, did you know that in 1975, Bohemian Rhapsody was released on Halloween, and it actually stayed on the charts for 17 weeks. Nine of them, it was number one, and it eventually went platinum. Then the song was re-released in December of 91 after being featured in the movie Wayne's World. Super classic. Love that movie. And it was a hit all over again. So on Friday, the 2nd of November, the Queen movie is actually going to be on, or in theaters, going to be released, excuse me. And I'm sure that the song is going to go number one again. It's a great one. And on that note, we're going to get back into the music. Jim, what do we have on deck?
Nirvana, Queen, and Metallica.
Nice. Enjoy those tunes, and we'll be back after that.
Legacy, caught in a landslide, no escape from reality. Open your eyes, look up to the skies and see. I'm just a poor boy, I need no sympathy, because I'm easy come, easy go, little high, little low. Anyway the wind blows, doesn't really matter.
Get out! everyone. I want to tell you all about an amazing salon. Joyce's, located at 132 Ferry Street in Everett, Massachusetts. Joyce's specializes in the latest techniques in coloring, styling, cutting, and beach waves. Joyce's features Sukesha all-natural nutrient products and organic color. Joyce's full-service spa and salon, located at 132 Ferry Street, Everett, Massachusetts. 617-387-6680. Specializing in you.
And welcome back to Rock Talk. So those are some good tunes we listened to. Today's birthdays. Let's see who's having a birthday today. Joey Belladonna from Anthrax. He's 58 today. Timothy Schmidt from the Eagles. He's 71. And then tomorrow on Halloween, Vanilla Ice turns 50. Grace Slick is going to be 79. Wow. From Jefferson Starship. And then November 1st, we have Rick Allen from Def Leppard. He's going to be 55. Dan Peek from America, he'll be 68. And let me see. On the 2nd, we have Bobby Dell from Poison. He's going to be 55. And Carter Buford from the Dave Matthews Band. Yep, he's going to be 61. And then on the 3rd, Adam Ant, love him. He's going to be 64, along with Puff Daddy. He's going to be 49. So happy birthday to those rock and rollers. And we're going to get back into the music. We have on deck some Led Zeppelin.
Ozzy Osbourne and Van Halen.
Sweet. Enjoy those tunes.
Don't ever let me be. I only wanna be by your side. Please don't ever let me be. I only wanna be by your side.
Are you hangry? Know the signs. Uncontrollable yelling.
Why aren't you egg rolls?
Hallucination.
Sushi.
Pants discomfort.
I hate you, pants.
Hangry. It can happen to anyone. Fortunately, there's E24, the app that tells hunger to shut up.
Egg rolls. Thanks, Snoop.
E24. In my medical opinion, it's the best way to order food online, baby.
And welcome back to Rock Talk. So, this week in rock and roll history, in 1977, Steve Perry makes his first concert appearance with Journey at the Old Waldorf in San Francisco. And he would lead them to a 17 Billboard chart toppers over the next 10 years. That's pretty amazing. And then The Doors, Jim Morrison was sentenced to 6 months in jail and fined $500 after he exposed himself during a concert. And actually, the case would still be on appeal, but he had he passed away on the 3rd of July in 1971. Sad. 27 years old. He's in the 27th Club. And Pink Floyd, they made their first U.S. debut at the Winterland Ball in Ballroom in San Francisco, and that was in 1967. And the tour would come to an early halt because Syd Barrett, he was displaying a lot of strange behavior. He wouldn't lip sync on the American Bandstand, and then he wouldn't answer certain questions on the Pat Boone Show. So those were two great shows that I grew up with. I wish they had things like that still, but of course they don't. Let's see, what else happened? I already told you about Bohemian Rhapsody. And then Dwayne Allman, he was killed when he lost control of his motorcycle in Georgia trying to swerve to avoid a tractor trailer, and that was just 3 weeks shy of his 25th birthday. I didn't realize that he had passed so young. He always seemed a lot older, and he was such a great musician. One of my favorites. I love the Allman Brothers Band. Anyway, on that note, we're going to get back into the music, and we're going to listen to some Thin Lizzy. So enjoy that. We're going to get back into the music.
Thank you.
that you love me. Never would you leave me. But the devil take that woman, for you know she treat me easy. But she'll ring dumb a do dumb a da.
Thank you.
And thanks again for Sargasm for stopping in to Rock Talk USA and sharing their great music with us. You can find their fan page on Facebook. Just look for Sargasm, S-A-R-G-A-S-M. And I will be linking all of their music and other things, videos and stuff, on the Rock Talk USA website. So look for that. And we're going to be closing out the night with some Werewolf of London. And have a happy, safe Halloween, and enjoy, and don't take any candy from strangers. How does that work? Anyhow, good night, and I will be back with you Tuesday, 8 p.m. Pacific, 11 p.m. Eastern on ARM Radio.
Traitor Vicks. His hair was perfect.